asked to introduce Mohammed Idris. He's 81 years old. He's born in India. His early education was in India, and then he came to Malaysia with his father. After which, at the age of 12, he went back to India again. I mean, a bit emotional because
من یه ترجمه خیلی نزدیک باز می‌کنم. ایشون آیه محمد ادریس رو معرفی می‌کنند که در هندوستان به دنیا آمدن ولی از 12 سالگی رفتن به مالزی و حالا بعد ادامه فعالیتاشون
رو When he went back to India at the age of 12, World War II disrupted his studies. He lost his father.
در 12 سالگی که دوباره برگشتن به هند همزمان با جنگ جهانی دوم بود و اون موقع ایشون پدرشون از دست داد.
From then on, his grandparents and his parents were his teachers, were his educators, and he got his education also from the madrasas, and he was also in Aligarh. He came back to Penang, Malaysia, at a very early age to help run the family business.
اون موقع ایشون آموزششون رو از پدر بزرگ و مادر بزرگشون گرفتن و در این مدارسی که رفتن و بعد اومدن به مالزی در پننگ و اونجا شروع کردن به تدریس.
And he was very involved when he was in India in this independence struggle and that's why he's always been a fighter. And till today he still, in fact, he still fights for a lot of independence and we thought that we had attained independence and Malaysia did, in fact, we just celebrated our 50th independence on the 31st of August. But till today, Mr. Idris feels we have not actually surrendered ourselves. We have not actually gained the independence we are supposed to get because we are still embedded in many things that the colonial people have left us.
از اون موقعیشون در مبارزات استقلال هند درگیر بودن و بعد هم در مالزی تا همین هفته گذشته 31 آگست 50مین سال استقلالش رو جشن گرفت منتها ایشون هنوز معتقدن که ما اون استقلال واقعی رو از آن چیزهایی که در ذهن و وجود ما از فرهنگ استعمار مونده هنوز رها نشد
And he always tells us that we should be our own masters.
نکته اصلی که ما بتونیم خودمون صاحب خودمون باشیم و پرده چیزی نباشیم.
When he was the early years in Penang, in fact, he was very involved during the independence days before Malaysia gained its independence. He was also involved in something called a goodwill committee. In Malaysia, we have got different ethnic groups. We have the Malays, the Chinese, the Indians, and the other groups. There's a lot of racial tension. And he was very, very involved in the northern states of Malaysia to get these groups together to become as one. And I think for 50 years after that, we have been very close. Different ethnics, different religions, different people, different culture, different food, but we have been one. And he was quite involved in that struggle also.
الصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. And as always, wish, of course, blessing of God, blessing and peace on all of us. There's been a long introduction which I don't deserve. No, there was yet enough in Germany. Dominating factor. And also we must purge out of their purge from them the inferiority complex which is deeply in them. You can see in many respects, this inferiority comes in many forms. Either the admiration for the language, admiration for their dress, admiration for the academic, admiration for their fast food, admiration from their busy things, all types of forms.
Organization of health is a state of complete physical, mental and social well-being and not merely the absence of disease or infirmity.
which brings in like the wholesomeness.
But in recent years, in addition of physical and mental and social, spiritual in recent years, in this definition, bring spiritual, not mental, spiritual. Spiritual well-being.
On or wherever it happens, because you really need to share what you're doing in Malaysia, 30 years experience of this stuff, confronting the corporations, the advertising, the healthcare professionals. You've got a track record and you've got a methodology, and you also know how to read the fine print and all these global agreements that are supposed to benefit everybody. I would challenge you, maybe the young guys here that are doing medical stuff, somebody, send a delegation for a month, 2 months or whatever, and learn that stuff, and then come back here and directly set up Consumer Association of Tehran to replicate that work with the local context in mind. Because here they don't have Coke and Pepsi, but they have Zemzem, which is this, it's basically a different name, but it's replicating the same sugar-laden formula. So to denounce Coke and Pepsi, be like, yeah, down with Coke and Pepsi, drink Zemzem. That's not what you want, right? You want to problematize the local.
Hasta Nisnama and Nista Hasnama, that we told you last time, is that there is Hast is being that we can see, and Nist is we can't see, the invisible and the visible. Okay, and he says that some things are Hast, they are what are is to be, but we don't see them. And some things that are Nist, that we shouldn't see, they act like they, we should see them. They become Hast. So he says, Hasta Nisnama and Nista Hasnama. And of course, it has many other interpretations too. But I think one thing that for our health issues and for the environment and eating habits comes with our dress. Just the dress that we are taking on the Western look, this Pepsi Cola, the fast food, goes with that kind of dress. You know, like wear jeans so you can, I don't know, have a hamburger. Even in the advertisements, they have that. You look cute with a jean and like if you have a hamburger in your hand, but not if you have like Halim. Or if you sit at home and you want to relax and sit with a family, you don't dress like that. I think that the niche that's becoming this has is coming through our clothes. And like with me, with my hijab, I won't go to all places because I have hijab and people know that. But the other thing, to buy the things that I'm buying to eat, I stop thinking about that. And I think that's something very important that we really have to start thinking, how am I looking physically that is really influencing what I'm buying to go into my stomach, to suit that too. And fit my outfit. They really definitely fit my outfit. The dishes I eat in, the portions I eat, all of that goes with the dress I'm wearing. Even though some of them are so tight.
Yes, we can make a paper mache. We can make baskets from that, we can make puppets from that, many things. No, you have to put the strips in the water.
I know, but when I was a child, it needed a kind of...
Every time you're trying to do something, someone's phone is ringing. It's really a headache. Yes? Once I was...
It's ringing. Huh?
It rings.
Classroom. Everywhere.
Everywhere. Once I was in a garden with my friends and everyone had a phone. I don't keep a phone for this reason. Many reasons, but this is one. You see? Even him. He's trying to do something and it's ringing. In 1 hour, I was sitting with 10 friends. Everyone's phone was been getting up and having to talk on their phone. They couldn't enjoy that we're just sitting here in this lovely garden for 1 hour we have. Let's enjoy and just talk and be together. No, this is when he has to get up. She has to get up. He has to get up.
The first thing I found
this is a small process. So that's time. But it looks nice. Then we'll make another, and another, and another, and it will be the...
The skill is not as important today. What is important is the integrity and the honesty of the action and the searching. And if we can... what I was saying, the seeds of freedom. If we can nurture those within ourselves, they will... The only way is if we have to have them within ourselves. As an idea, as a separate external thing. Yeah. So only if it's within ourselves, then I have a great faith it'll be carried on by others. And maybe this is not exactly the time. For me, this is the time of... not of spreading things like that. It's a time of deepening things to the integrity and getting back to the honesty of those things. And if that's what we have to learn. Otherwise, what's happening is so many things are being spread. Like I give an example, yoga. The way it's spread is not the real thing at all. It's just some stretching, that. Because with the whole philosophy, the deepening, the connection with things, that's not being. And so I had one friend in Yunnan. She'll drive 1 hour in her car to go to her yoga class. Then she goes to the yoga class. Then she goes to the office, sits in the office for like 6 hours or 8 hours doing something she doesn't like even. Then, because she doesn't like it, she smokes in the day. It's not real. You know, and she said, I'm a yoga teacher. I said, what yoga teacher are you? Yeah, yeah, it's the silliness that happens right now. So this deepening of the things, the people who are understanding this, I mean, my interest is, I mean, just like, many of these things are understanding. So how can we, within ourselves and as friends, deepen that within each other? Because sometimes we get caught up when we need to spread it so much. But then our own continuous going into it, getting back to something that is much more honest and in tune with, in harmony. If we start to live it, see, I told you the word for guru. Guru, you know guru?
Guru.
G-U-R-U.
No.
People say teacher, but the original meaning is not teacher. Guru is source of inspiration.
Guru. Huh? Mm-hmm.
Ustad. But the root of the meaning is source of inspiration. So by living it, you don't have to teach anybody. You're living it honestly, people themselves will be attracted. Because our faith is there are still people who want to live honestly. That's the and we have to find each other. That's part of it. But we also have to, we can only find each other when we're doing it ourselves. We think, this is, I used to be in UNESCO in Paris. And I think, I'm not living anything I'm talking about. This is, I felt dishonest. And as soon as I moved back to India, I started living these things. And so many people, like all of these friends, started coming into my life. So there's a very different way to do it. And you know.
1919, yeah?
You start living this more and more experiments with, for example, zero oil. I'm sure many people will be starting to connect in who are genuinely interested in that.
My question is that the rate of growth of other things is so much higher than us while we try to deepen these methods within ourselves without spreading. And then one day, eventually, this
will die. Well, it's again the seeds. No, I know, but I'm saying if you think of it, for me it's a metaphor of seeds. So at certain, there's certain spaces where the spreading happens, there's certain spaces where the rooting is happening, there's certain points in time and history where that isn't. So understanding that also, I think that I'm very deeply worried about the rate of destruction. But if we just agree or we just keep talking about it, unless we are also living the alternatives, it doesn't become real.